Hi there, welcome back. So today we are going to talk about pandas profiling. So suppose you have a small data set and someone asked you to generate a quick EDA analytical report and share with a person who is a layman in programming. So in that case, you should blindly go with the pandas profiling module. Because it literally, you know, it gives you a very good EDA report in just 2 to 3 minutes, hardly. So to install this pandas profiling, you just need to go with the pip install command, and here you see that I have imported, let's run it from pandas profiling, import this profile report method. So yeah, so this will generate our EDA report. So I'm using here iris data, so we are ready with the iris data frame. So now to generate the profile report, we will input the iris data frame to the profile report method. So let's run it. So you see that, no, it's summarizing data set, and we'll see further few steps generating report structure, then it will render to HTML file, and finally it will export that file to export that report to the HTML file. So now we generated the report, and to visualize the profile report, you need to go to the directory where your this notebook is. So there you will see a file named output.html. So let's see. So you see that, you know, output.html generated seconds ago. So let's view this file. So you see that, you know, we in starting it has it shows overview of the data frame, iris data frame, complete data set statistics, variable types. So, and the interesting thing is it also shows warnings, you know, if data set has any duplicate rows or the set of attributes which are highly correlated with some other attributes, or some warnings related to distribution. Like here you can see that species attribute is uniformly distributed. So this is a interesting thing here. So going down, you see that for all the variables, like here for example, let's go for sepal length, you'll see the basic statistics and the distribution, and if you toggle details, you'll see more like all the, you know, a quantile plus descriptive statistics, lots of figure, then histogram, and common values also, you know, with count, with frequency, then extreme values, outliers. This is interesting thing, right? So minimum 5 outlier and the maximum 5 outlier. So you can see, so yeah, so all this values for you know, for each attribute, you'll see the for sepal length, for petal length. So in warnings, if you remember, you know, we saw that petal length is highly correlated with petal width, and same for petal width also. So you see, so now under interaction, you'll see kind of, you know, the relationship between sepal, suppose here sepal width and sepal length. You see, it's so when you choose sepal width, sorry, petal length, sepal width versus petal length, you will see relationship, you know, how what's the trend going on between these two attributes. So going forward, then you'll see correlations, heat map, you'll see, so different type of correlations, Pearson, Spearman, Kendall. So if you toggle, you'll see, you know, some descriptive info about each correlation type. So then going down, you'll see missing values. So for this iris data frame, we don't have any missing values, because if you see at the top, you know, missing cells 0, so that's why we don't see here. It doesn't show any missing values. So then under sample, you'll see, you know, first n rows for all the attributes, and then first n rows and last n rows for all the attributes. See. Then duplicate rows. So you can see that, you know, pandas profiling, you know, very nicely generated a simple, straightforward, you know, analytical report, self-explanatory report. So you can, yeah, if, but remember, you know, it's good only for small data set. So I hope it helped you. Thank you. See you. Bye-bye.